It was a pretty extensive list. We had some fun shooting it, but not nearly as much fun as we're going to have in a little bit when it comes to the Derby cars. No, the Derby cars did not make the list because not everyone gets a chance to do it, but you get a chance to see it coming up at the fair and actually a little bit later in the show. But if you happen to be riding through Platte City, there are four things that we laid out that you must see, you must do, and these are the four right here. If you've been scouring the earth looking for a time machine, look no further than here in Platte City, because the Platte City Museum is the place you want to go if you want to go back to the 1900s.
I think they walk back in time, and the floor plan is a blueprint for how people lived years ago. So we try to show that, from the raising of purebred horses with part of our exhibit, we have a beautiful oil painting on loan, to fashions from 1912 through 1929.
I think people need to know history. And I think this is a good place to find it out. I'm very proud to be a native Platte Countyan that has been very important to me through my life.
This mini mansion was built to resemble the governor's mansion, and it's called the People's House of Missouri. Well, this is kind of the People's House of Platte County. So I think if they come, they'll get a flavor for the entire area.
And that's why this is a must stop on our list. Our next stop honors men and women who've served in our military, and it also happens to weigh 13 tons, and it's right here in downtown Platte City. This anchor once sat on the USS Platte. It was salvaged from the country's second Navy warship, named after the area's rivers. If you think the anchor is large, think about how big the ship this came from was. The ship could hold 180,000 barrels of oil and another 600 tons of supplies. The USS Platte was responsible for providing fuel and other essential items to other military vessels on the water, helping refuel and recharge thousands of servicemen and women. And that's why this memorial is a must-stop on our list. This next stop is for those of you that like to break a little sweat either before or after work or on the weekends at one of the nicest trails in the entire county. Sitting just south of the city, the Prairie Creek Greenway is a four-mile trail that's been open since 2006. It's a must-go stop for bikers and joggers wanting to take in some fresh air and enjoy the sounds of nature. Changes are coming to the park, though. Soon, there will be an additional 7.8-mile trail. And that's why you and your four-legged friend should stop by here, and that's why we've added it on our must-stop list. Our next stop is for those of you that like the taste of fermented grapes, Jowler Creek Winery. With several awards to its name, this winery is always open for tasting events, featuring plenty of options to choose from. No need to wait, just show up and let the tastings begin. And yes, there are a variety of cheeses and snacks ready for your enjoyment. And that's why Jowler Creek is a must-stop on our four must-stops here in Platte City. And honestly, the cars have gotten here, and these are going to be a must drive coming up in a little bit. You got team stock cars on the right, you got Mark Alford's car in the middle, and of course you got some standard stock cars on the left side, Derby cars. We're going to get in these bad boys a little bit later, coming up in an hour. Mark Alford, we're going to clean off that seat for you, the blue stars and stripes. And Nick and Abby, you can probably judge on who is going to look best driving that car. My vote is, of course, me. But we got an hour to figure that out. We'll send it back to you guys in the studio.